for the opening ceremony of the International Sustainability Olympiad for students. UNESCO is really proud to welcome more than 300 students and their supervisors from 40 different countries. We are here today with students from Albania, from Mali, from Mexico, from Brazil, from Indonesia, from Mexico, from Croatia. From all over the world, you come to the Netherlands to bring your ideas for a new future. And when I was invited to this Olympiad, I was thinking, what can I tell these youngsters about sustainability? What do I do for a better future, cleaner, healthier environment? Well, of course, I bring my magazines, newspapers, cans and bottles to a recycling point. And of course, I bring batteries to a chemical deposit. I'm traveling as much as possible by train. I put out the lights when I leave my home, but that's it. Almost everybody does that. Well, today I started with this little sustainability project, Zero Plastic Week. This whole week I will not buy anything plastic. I can use the plastic in my house, the plastic I already have, but I will not buy any new plastic. And to be honest, this was not my idea. It was because of my son. The past few weeks he was doing this school project about plastic soup. A floating plastic garbage island in the great ocean, which is as big as the countries of France and Spain together. And when he was searching the internet on plastic soup, he told me, Mom, do you know that in an African country, Rwanda, plastic bags are forbidden? And it's also in 50 cities in the state of California, USA. No more plastic bags. And why are we still wrapping everything in plastic? And while I was thinking of an answer, he already found this project on the internet, Zero Plastic Week. So no plastic for me this whole week, no plastic for my family this whole week, and it starts today. And I told him, son, no cereals for you this week, no potato chips, no candies. And he said, well, that's not a problem. I found this internet shop and that sells candies in paper bags. So, no problem for me, he said. So, of course, this project doesn't change the world. But it still is a nice project, and it's making people aware about environment and about health issues, about pollution. But besides these awareness projects, we need bigger, greater ideas. And maybe today we find among your plans one of those ideas that maybe will change our future of our planet. And my son, when he was doing this research about this plastic soup, he found this remarkable presentation on the internet about removing and recycling the huge amount of plastic driven in the ocean. And it was funny because it was the animation made by Herman Bergwerf, a 14-year-old student, and he was last year the winner of the UNESCO 2011. And I can say that thanks to Herman Bergwerf, my son is more interested in the environment and sustainability. And of course, he still wants to be a soccer player at Ajax. But he told me, if Ajax doesn't want me, maybe I will become an engineer. So. And I hope in a couple of years that my son, my daughters, and my students also are standing here like you and presenting their plans at the UNESCO Olympiads like you do. And I'm very excited by seeing youngsters from all over the world joining together to find ways to work together for a new future. You are demonstrating to the public and to politicians a hope for the future. A lot of people are very pessimistic about the future, and that isn't the way about bringing change. Your enthusiasm is very, very important. Thank you for that.